I was really disappointed that time when you did that straight away. Do you remember? I don't know what I've just told you. Yeah. Wasn't proper. Yeah, there's loads of peer pressure as well. All the people ran off the ball. I come off a really rough council estate. And I mean rough. Dad was proud of his when he got old, when they had it well up there. Got himself out of it. I told you about my mum and dad this weekend, didn't I? And they went out every night and got pissed. And come in and drank brandy and whiskey. And they told Mary a weekend was when they went out. And when they went out was Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. And 2 nights where they didn't go out. And I thought that was a weekend. I didn't have a bed from when I was 11 till 16. I slept downstairs on the couch. Playing with the dog, but to bite my sleeping bag. You've had a good upbringing, haven't you?
More civil than yours, I guess.
Not perfect.
My parents argued a bit, but...
You talk. I wouldn't say posh, but you're correct. It's a nice correct. I think the way you talk's lovely. It's not bothering you, is it? It's the one paper. What's there? do feel strange if you don't go out, if you go out without your glasses. Do you feel like something missing? When you first start wearing them, I get really uncomfortable about if I wear certain stuff. When you first start wearing them, were you conscious of people might be looking at you?
I think it's the ear defence more than anything.
What's the
Or the combination of, you know, the ear defenders on the sunglasses.
What would you do when you were abroad? Would you like it or not? In the sun?
Yeah, I'd be alright with decent enough sunglasses.
Do you grieve about your dad much?
This was a shitty deal he got, really. He got sent off to a care home and then he knows he's dead within 6 months.
Is that because he... Did he get Alzheimer's or...?
It was kind of, yeah, he had dementia and... He set the house on fire, so...
What did he set the house on fire?
It's not really that clear, but... He was... I don't know, he set fire to a settee in the lounge somehow. It's not really clear whether he was trying to light the open fire we had or... Or what he was doing.
Was it covered by the insurance? Do you look like your dad?
I don't know really.
I don't think you look like your mum.
I guess it's kind of hard to say. My dad was quite, like, you know, he was pretty old, but. I don't see that much resemblance between me and my brother and my dad, but...
Do you not see your brother?
Okay, never mind.
Did he come and see you?
Very rarely came on my birthday.
And he's in contact or not?
Not really, no.
Four years between you. Is there a lot of sibling rivalry?
No.
Is he married?
Yeah, he's just had a kid a few months ago. Got married about a year ago, so. He's got a pretty good setup. He's sure his wife a good job, and we were living in Ingleby Bower, which my brother hated. He wanted to live in the countryside. I don't know how much it was he convinced her or what, but now they've got this nice house in the village near where my mum lives. We went to stay there when couldn't stay in the house after the house fire. His wife threw me out because she couldn't handle me.
Didn't she?
Sick of her. I'm sick of your behaviour, your sullen behaviour, and hearing things about.
What sort of sulking about?
How I am, just not talking.
A nice pill, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Are you aware of nice people? And does it make you do it more?
Well, I mean, when people aggravate me, it makes me more quiet, more. Don't want anything to do with them, so.
Like you do with me? Like that. Oh, I see, yeah. So what did you mean by sulking about? What did you do?
It wasn't anything specific, you know, it's just...
Because you didn't talk?
I'm just, I don't know, strange and annoying, I guess.
It's a bit hard to understand, I think. It's difficult to talk to. Can you do it just to ask the different word? When to say? I did in West Park.
Mm-hmm.
What's that word?
Tenacious.
I did go on and on, didn't I? Can you remember I was trying to get you with the Anita head first? Phone number, and I don't know why I was doing it because I liked you, and I thought to myself, what the fuck are you doing? And that's when I started. So it. Stalking you. Well, for want of a better word. I don't think she was very happy. Zara's not too pleased because she's been trying to contact her and she's not responding to any of her calls or anything.
She's probably got out with her.
Nice lad, him. He looked like he had a few weeks over at his, and he come into the where you walk around to the wards and looked absolutely dishevelled and totally exhausted. And you know, normally he tells jokes and he's funny and that. It's just like, huh? He absolutely looked. I felt sorry for him. God, what are you doing to him? I finished these fluids in there, I'm going to pop them in. Can you believe it when you said you had one? Oh, what they got one for?
I had a big dog, sold a shisha pipe. A Middle Eastern thing. it's like tobacco with like fruit stuff in it. Kind of the smoke, somewhat similar to those. You have this long hose and you take a draw on it and then you get all these big clouds of vapor.
They still got it?
No, I think I had it at Darlington. I remember smoking in my bedroom and then a load of shit got left behind when I moved on.
Well, you wouldn't pack your stuff. You refused, you sat in the dining room. With bare feet. And outside on the bench. I felt dead sorry for you. Didn't know where you were going or anything. He should have shown you where you were going and you'd have freaked out even more, I think.
Yeah, it was a nightmare on that first day because one of the nurses was a right bitch.
Is that the one that took the little as you come off here?
So it's going to be a disaster then. As time goes on, they just tend to give up on you and leave you alone.
Can you remember them coming in and telling you, you're going, you are going to Earlston House? And I spoke for you, and she said, he can speak himself. You need to speak for him. Can you remember? Super nice to me now. I don't know why.
You do what you're doing.
I don't know why. I've got a clue. I think probably because she can see now that I do have a lot of, or I've had a lot of psychiatric problems. And for good reason. because they read the notes of Alex and stuff like that. Vegetarian?
No. Doesn't really count you as vegetarian.
No.
It doesn't sound like you've made a decision to stop eating meat.
I have.
Yeah.
I'm vegetarian, I've got meat and everything going.
I kind of did a bit of West Park and then too much effort telling them every time I'm vegetarian.
What happens to our relationship? Generally.
Mm. The public ship might be actually. There was such a shitstorm about it now, everyone at Earlston knows, so someone will probably tell her. They always fucking tell her everything that annoys the fuck out of them. When I was out the other night, they'd rang her, and she was all worried. And so I was supposed to ring her when I'd gone back in, because she was all concerned. I was like, why did you ring her? They were looking at me as if, like, you know, I was a bad person for concerning them and shit.
Things can get better for you, you know. Seem to go in the right direction. Do something that you can do that you love, that makes you money. Not indulging in mental money that you make her. Fancy to start doing that for a living. Table push through the best place. I'm not eating that. That's putting all them in my mouth. Oh, God. Thank you. I wonder if Earlston Hill's phone West Park says yeah.
Quite possible.
And the other way around. How many people are talking about me now?
Like I say, they all know Ulster, the last formulation meeting thing I had to tell them. You have some friend from West Park, you go and see. Do you see her every day?
What's that got to do with in the formulation meeting?
Well, just wondering what I'm doing with my time. I don't know about ramping up my meds, I don't know. I haven't had them for ages, but...
What do you want about putting them up?
Yeah. I was like, the risperidone's made a difference. Not really trying to sound too positive about it. I'm like, oh well, we can increase that. It's not a high dose, you know. Like 3 milligrams for someone who isn't psychotic is a pretty high dose.
Just let them take it up and just don't take them. I've got more chance. I told you before about DLA. If you let us do it for you.
But, I don't know. Need to start at least pretending to take them again, otherwise I'll probably think all this drama recently is because I've gone off my meds.
That was £55 a week, you know. And it's not taking into consideration of your money now. Not taking into consideration, though. It also increases your infirmed spot allowance by £58 as well. So, it's over 100 quid. I need a computer, I need a laptop or a computer keyboard for the... I've done loads of them, it's all been successful. I'm selling nothing, £100 a week, but I make a difference. I use the centre of the pack. And I put it in. So it's a centre of the pack pack for you. I'll just get two clips for then I'll put it in for you. So you can either do it on the internet or send it for like whatever. Do you want us to send for it? And so on, no. It's not an ancestor. Matching odd socks on, I said to you earlier on. Matching odd socks. station. Yeah, they took it there, but...